What happens when you put 1,000 players in one hardcore Minecraft world, but one half lives on an island filled with animals, resources, and rich nature, while the other inhabits a desolate, unforgiving wasteland? Well, I joined Ish's 1,000 player rich versus poor experiment, and today we're going to find out. For this event, I joined up with some of my close friends to found the Conquistadors, conquerors of all things cheese. Our master plan for this limited event was to find the holy motherload of cheese to please our glorious rat queen, and oh boy were we dedicated. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the story of the Conquistadors. On day one, our primary goal was to group up all of our members in one place, set up farms, basic infrastructure, you know the deal. And so, we began to gather our people on the eastern coast of the island. As one of the Conquistadors' leaders, or as we were calling ourselves, the Queso Capitans, I had a certain authority over these people, which made my main objective for the day to make sure everyone made it to the rendezvous safely. Although this process was going well, there were certainly other matters to attend to. It's time to meet some of the other Capitans.
Thank you, average Christians. I really do. You want that bag? Okay. Is that what you're showing? Oh, to Magmar. Oh, you're his butler.
Wait, that's you?
Oh yeah, that's
the butler.
No way.
Yeah. I don't know. Not talking. I could have just said I was a butler. Okay, hello.
Oh, I think
the lore is I can only speak if I'm given permission. So I needed Magmar to tell me to speak.
He may speak for you.
Last time I tried that, he hit me and hid me in the closet for 3 days. So I've learned my lesson.
You have permission to speak freely.
This was Pigeons, and for some godforsaken reason, he had decided to pledge himself to me and act as my loyal butler for the duration of this event. I was intrigued by this, and it certainly had the potential to be, well, see for yourself.
Yeah, sorry, Magmar, you're too British for this conversation.
I'm
butler, you gonna let her speak to me like that?
Permission to kill?
Although getting to know my fellow Conquistadors was fun, we could not possibly let ourselves get distracted from our great quest for queso. An objective that we were reminded of much earlier than I had anticipated.
Okay, all right, listen very carefully, okay? Yeah. I have two things to tell you. First of all, I was given this.
What? Oh! We have a taste. We have a taste.
Of the true power.
Can have a nibble.
A taste, just a
yes,
nibble.
Yes, you can have a nibble. You can have the nibble. We only have one.
Oh, one shit. And only one.
Okay.
It is the only one in existence.
I licked
right
it. Oh, it's okay. So good.
Mm. It's so good. Mm. This, we need to guard even more than this.
Okay.
We must guard this with our lives.
Okay.
The second thing is that Solo was speaking with us, Trey, right?
Mm-hmm.
And he said, and I quote, "There's something much more dangerous than a Ravager on this world. Don't dig too deep."
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. I want to. I really want to find out.
No, you can't, Trey. Please,
Trey. You can't. Trey. We can't. We need you. We need you.
No,
we have to send a poor soul
down
here.
I'll send the butler down.
Send the butler. Okay. Let's go. Okay.
And with a taste of cheese on the tip of our tongues, it was time to get geared up.
Nice. Magmar, would you go mining with me?
I would love to go mining with you, dude.
The next day, we awoke to marvelous news. One of our scouts came to visit us Capitans with some information for us regarding the island.
This place is way bigger than we thought yesterday. There's an island within the island, so this is not the eastern coast. It's the inner coast. Across that lake, there is a little landmass that's perfect for what we have planned.
It didn't take us long to set up a small home base for farming, livestock, and resources. And resources would be an extremely important part of our base because, you see, hunting cheese was not our only goal for this event. The Conquistadors also sought to construct a glorious temple, a mega build that could rival anything. And where there's a build project, there's a head builder.
What's up? It's me, Pissnubs.
Zappy Nubs was spearheading our mega build, and it was during the planning that we realized that we were not alone on this island. A man named Captain Lights had begun constructing arbitrary fences around our land, claiming them as national park territory and demanding that they remain unspoiled by our builds. And as a group of mostly builders, well, we couldn't just let that slide, now could we?
Fellas, we may need to take down a national park.
So, while Zappy and Turkey made plans to retake the national park, Trapex told me that most of the island's leadership were meeting later that day to have a chat about their plans the next week. And although the Conquistadors planned on being a mostly neutral faction, we still thought it would be worth attending. And so, a delegation containing Jesus Christ himself was sent to the leader summit.
Governments that aren't peaceful. It's the governments that are actually warmongering that we need to be working on, that we need to be cooperating with, or that we need to be preparing for.
The Commonwealth has, for quite a while, was founded on the idea that we would build a mutual city together. Now, we're not going to, I don't think anyone should be forced to create a single city, but for reasons of defense, I do believe it may be prudent to, if we don't unite, at least create a single settlement together that we could either fall back to, or at least a fortress.
What if someone wants to be part of the mutual defense agreement, but then they don't want to move? What is the recourse for you then?
Well, that's up to you entirely, but I'm just saying that as well, that if you're in a mutual defense pact and we're not able to reach you in time if an invasion happened and you were the target, you've mentioned yourself that you guys are scared of Island One. We're all scared of Island One. We should be close enough together that we can work together to combat Island One, should they supposedly attack.
I don't think the fear and animosity is going to help anybody. I don't think we
Agreed.
Should be scared of Island One so much as we should be prepared for Island One.
Everyone in favor of a mutual defense pact in which one nation gets attacked, we all come to their aid, say aye.
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 We all agree to attack each other. Aye.
Aye.
You'll be sending a huge colossal aid package to Island One to help those struggling in poverty, in hunger, and in strife. Aye.
Aye.
But before everyone goes, I would like to ask you all to at least consider the prospect of unification and the benefits it may have, and to disregard your own personal beliefs and your own personal power.
That's just in general, we are very much open to just mutually having each other's backs and like a non-aggression pact. Our problem is mostly just that it could devolve into a point where we're preparing to defend ourselves against a danger that doesn't exist yet.
Exactly.
Which could come across very unfavorably to members of Island One who are coming over to visit us.
That's kind of why I'm emphasizing the aid thing more than anything
yes.
else.
I think what we have to be wary of is Luminara versus Imperion.
Oh, it's fear-mongering and nothing more. They're preparing to fight a war that isn't real.
Fellas! Whatever you're doing is going to have to wait. We have visitors.
As it turned out, we were nowhere near the only faction on the Center Island, with representatives of the groups of Mattel and Calyx Celestialis both at our front door to discuss land distribution. Now, although many other groups may have simply scoffed in their faces, we were not a violent one, and after hearing them out, neither were they. We decided to form a pact, agreeing to stay in touch with each other and to split the land evenly, uniting our three factions under the political banner of the Triumvirate. This gave our assembled player base more of a say in political meetings, as we now represented a coalition rather than just one group, while still remaining independent factions outside of island politics. The first thing we agreed on as a coalition, the National Park guy, had to go.
Okay, listen. This is our land. Listen, we've thought about your offer from yesterday. We really have. And it's not going to work, right? I don't know if you can kind of read the room, but we kind of have a few numbers here. Listen, yeah, it's not that we hate nature. It's that we are trying to build here and you are simply just getting in our way. So
I hate nature.
You're going to go ahead and you're going to just leave us.
I hate nature.
Park. And if you keep making walls in spots like this, we're going to have a problem. That's just that simple. Listen, I didn't want it to come to this, man.
Yeah, this is a very sad day. I don't know what to tell you, honestly. I don't know what to tell you right now, but...
I don't know why they're circling you. I'm going to be honest. I didn't really want this. It just kind of happened. This is making it very awkward atmosphere for, like, talking, but, like, you know... group hug?
Whoa, that's a sign of aggression.
With Captain Light finally gone, I decided to work on some building, and yet, I barely even managed to get started.
Dons!
Yeah, what's up?
Dude, we just watched the fucking murder unfold!
Wait, what's up? What happened?
The three of us were out scouting, and we noticed that someone was circling us out on the water. We thought that was suspicious, so we returned to the mainland and passed by this guy who said he was the leader of a faction just north of the base. He seemed nice enough, but we were in a hurry, so we didn't really think much of it.
And we were talking to people from Commonwealth, because we learned about their diplomacy, and the guy was like, oh, you can talk to Wolfram, right? Because he's right over there, like behind a house.
And then just as we left, the guy from the lake caught up and...
So, what you're saying is you just witnessed a political assassination, and that same assassin has been tailing you guys.
Yes.
We know this is a very stressful time. We're still currently figuring out how to assess the situation, how to figure out exactly what happened and why. We are not very sure, we are working on it. But in this difficult time, I think it's very important to remember what brought us together, and that is cheese! Para el queso!
Cheese!
Cheese! Cheese! Cheese! Cheese!
Cheese! Cheese! Cheese! Cheese! Cheese! Cheese! Cheese! Cheese!
By the looks of things, we had mostly managed to calm everyone down. After all, we weren't really at risk as long as we stuck together. And considering the meeting from day two, we had pretty solid connections to Jophiel and her nation, and concrete plans to reach out to the High Council of Aperion to form some sort of alliance. With this in mind, we could afford to take things easy for now. So for day four, the Conquistadors decided to focus on working on our mighty cheese temple.
How old were you when you found out that Santa Claus was in the world?
Wait, he's not?
Huh.
I also noticed that my trusty butler Pigeons was avoiding me today, and so I decided to confront him about it.
If you keep up this suspicious bullshit,
is that suspicious? It's
longer
fun.
Than you need to, then I'm gonna have to introduce you to Mr. Knifey Hands. And Mr. Knifey Hands,
okay, yeah, I can.
Is called listen, Mr. Knifey
I can,
Hands
I can,
for a reason.
I can. Does he have forks? Go back to your little Capitan meeting. I'll be here. Definitely, I won't be following you. Gotta wait. Abort mission, abort mission, abort mission.
But while we were working on the temple, Trapex struck a deal with the devil. If he could win a bullfight against a ravager, he would be granted 5 whole precious cheese blocks. And that was an offer that he just couldn't refuse.
Oh, Rat Queen, my Rat Queen, I bring the spoils of battle. 5 cubic meters of cheese.
I declare this cheese practical.
I was ecstatic. We'd made so much progress on Zappy's beautiful temple, and the place was really starting to come together. As the sun began to set, I just couldn't stop smiling. I awoke the next day to find our whole island in shambles. 2 major factions had just lost their entire leadership to an assassination, and considering that we had strong ties to both, that now left us not only vulnerable, but also on edge. In an act of panic, the entire island's leadership were invited to another meeting on neutral ground, and although there were concerns for it being yet another trap, we had to send someone to stay in the loop. Capitan's Canarian Turkey volunteered, and left as soon as the sun had risen.
So, who is the Saps guy again?
He's a bit of a wild card. He doesn't represent any faction, just attends these meetings to moderate them.
Well, that's not the impression I'm getting here. I think we should keep an eye on him, just in case.
Thank you.
there was foul play afoot. And the worst thing about it was that none of us had a clue. Someone had been pulling the strings since the very beginning, and yet the Conquistadors had no idea what was coming for them as they celebrated. Madsvi, the Queen Barbie, had invited us all to a beach party on her turf, and party we did, blissfully ignorant of what was soon to happen to the Rich Island. On day 6, we decided to take our time to do what we do best, building. Many of us felt that the best way to leave our mark on this event was through a huge build project, and oh boy did Zappy deliver. We got to work, and it was glorious. Working on the temple really brought us together, so much so that we decided to reach out to the poor soul that we had banished from this land a few days ago. Captain Lights was offered his own little slice of land within hours.
Oh, Captain Lights! Okay, listen to me, Captain Lights. Listen to me, Captain Lights. We got your national park. Let me show you. Oh, wait,
don't take it. See, look, it's got trees, it's got,
Yeah, it's perfect.
Hey, sweet game. That costs money to get in there, bro.
Yeah, dude, come on now.
Don't get in there.
You gotta pay that to Captain Lights.
Get in there.
Everybody get a picture.
Let's go!
Spirits were high, and we were having the time of our lives. As my fellow Conquistadors celebrated, partied, and cheesed all over the place, Trebex and I decided to leave for some fresh air. It was time for us to visit our neighbours and tour the Rich Island.
So there's this guy called Fran from a different nation, and little does he know, he's an international fugitive, and I've taken the burden of responsibility to capture him, drag him into our borders, and lock him away in my tower of rehabilitation. What are his crimes, you say? Well...
But instead of Fran, all we found was this guy.
No wait, dude, it's the wise mystical tree himself! Look at this!
Wise mystical tree.
It's tree of wisdom. Hey, wise mystical tree.
Hello.
Do you have any wisdom?
You guys all have shields.
Oh, he's so wise.
See?
He's all knowing.
He was fucking right.
Dude, how else would he know that? If he's all knowing, how else would he know that?
What other knowledge do you?
What knowledge?
That's a mushroom in your hand.
We returned home, where, to our surprise, a Conquistador named Super High Speed had officially created our national sport, shadowboxing. We spent the rest of the day holding a tournament, celebrating, and just spending time with each other. We had come so far already, and it was beautiful.
Welcome to shadowboxing. Each round, there's an attacker and a defender. You can choose to look up, down, left, or right. On my count, both of you will choose the direction to face. If both players look in the same direction, then the attacker wins that round. So, let's begin.
On day 7, the borders between the two great islands finally dropped. What followed was a huge influx of immigrants and visitors from the poor island, seeking our resources in a desperate attempt to aid their starving people. And with the hope of sending a message of peace instead of aggression towards any potential visitors, we reached out a friendly hand to the nation of Nevermore. I extended an invitation to their leader, Moon, setting up a resource trade across both islands. At the same time, Trey left on a diplomatic mission of his own. However, when Moon arrived on our doorstep, he brought less than favorable news.
Yeah, what's up?
Come with me, now.
Okay.
There's like 15 odd, Nevermore people here.
That, trade deal, I don't really know. So, like, there's been a coup.
Wait, really?
So, Varric, I placed in as Corvus in charge until I get back.
Yeah.
Has gathered everyone in the center of Nevermore, mm-hmm. and completely dissolved all of leadership.
So Nevermore's in a state of civil war right now. Hmm. Is that what I'm reading here?
Yes.
When I went to bring this up with Canary and Turkey, they had their own news for us. They had just returned from another leadership meeting, and, well, it looked like Nevermore wasn't the only coup that happened on the server today.
What just happened, basically, when the meeting adjourned, we had noticed that someone in the distance was spectating our meeting. We couldn't identify him just yet. However, about 2 minutes once after the meeting adjourned, as me and Canary were heading back to the temple, we see that the person who was identified as New Kids had just murdered 3 Below Zero.
That's terrifying.
Which is, yeah, it's very bad for us.
Yeah, just a bit.
Because then that means it's in our playground. It's going to be very hard for us to stay out of this now.
Well, to be fair, people are already coming around. I think we kind of just keep up the, you know, just keep up the friendly, you know. The thing is, we really don't have anything to hide, you know what I mean?
I do.
Yeah.
Like, we haven't done anything.
On behalf of the Commonwealth, we are officially in civil war. Ah, oh,
neat.
Shit.
Cool. Awesome.
That's so great.
This is awesome.
So that here's the best part. That means we are going to get involved. That's the best part because they're going to use the whole damn island. I think, remember the national park guy wanted to make a big fence? I think we go do that.
We should do that.
I think he had the right idea.
We were scared. With the murder conspiracy starting to spread, people started pointing fingers at the man who had been present for nearly every single leadership meeting without being a leader himself. At the man who had nothing to lose and everything to gain. Saparata. When we awoke the next day, everything was strangely quiet. Oddly enough, the only noise we experienced that morning was a surprise visit by good old Captain Lights.
Okay, what's going on here?
Hello there.
Oh, they're building more walls. I can't believe this. Wait, okay, they're up here. They're up here.
Okay, but that doesn't really, like...
Okay, listen here. Listen here. What's going on? What are you doing? Why are there walls everywhere? What are you doing?
Magic.
It's Mr. National Park over here.
Okay, Captain Lights.
What the hell is going on?
Are you not happy with the little area we built for you down there?
Oh, hi.
Because I don't really see why you wouldn't be. I mean, it has tree, it has plant, singular. We want you to go back to your little national park or leave. You are not welcome here.
No.
This is what the British did. They show up, they draw lines on maps, and claim old time, and everyone hates the British. Everyone hates them.
This is what the British did,
The national park guy came back and he brought two friends with us, right? Yeah, do you know what happened?
Friends?
He brought two buddies from Island One, like his backup.
Oh,
and then once
God.
They realized that none of us were taking Captain Light seriously, they both just ran away. And then, you know what we did next? Pumbaa then took him aside. It was like, oh, you know, we really can't have you guys making this national park here. But if you want to go over to Mattel, they've got plenty of space over there.
That's incredible, dude.
At that moment, Trapex returned from his voyage, and he wasn't alone. Trey, where have you been? Everything's been going crazy lately. You just went completely dark on us.
Look, I'm back now, but there's more important stuff to discuss. This is Legacy, okay? He's a citizen of Luminara. You know, that place we visited the other day. He really needs to talk to us.
Yeah, so, you know, Three Below, our leader, he got assassinated yesterday, right? And in his absence, one of the councilmen, Fluixon, just took the throne.
I remember him. He was at that leadership meeting ages ago, right, Trey? He sounded like he was off his rocker back then.
Here's the thing. We thought the same thing and got really mad at him for acting like that, because it just reflects badly on the entirety of Luminara. And ever since he took power, he's been calling for a witch hunt against that one guy that everyone suspects.
Who, Saps? I mean, honestly, he has good reason to. Saps has somehow been tied to every single murder so far.
Magmar, it's all a lie. Fluixon is behind everything. Like, every murder, every assassination, every single plot that's been on the island, he's been pulling the strings from the very start.
What? So Saps is just...
entirely innocent. We overheard him discussing it with his conspirators, and those four men have just been carefully taking out various nation leaders and framing Saps as a scapegoat, letting rumors build, and finally seizing power over Luminara, so that way Fluix can lead a charge against Saps and come out on top as the hero of his own story.
Right, so what exactly has kept y'all from killing him already?
He just has too many loyalists who either don't know or are in on it too. I guarantee they're not going to be happy with taking him out, but there is another option, which is why I came here. Tomorrow at sunrise, there's a raid we're building to rush Luminara while we keep Fluixon busy in the main city. That raid party can swarm in and take him out if we keep him in one place. We can set peace to this entire island and light to Luminara, most importantly, in my opinion. But we need to build a big enough raid party to do it. We sent diplomats across the entire island at this point, and we were hoping we could get at least a few in on it. Are you guys in?
Yeah, we'll be there.
Alright, what do you make of this, Trey?
I say we take a handful of conquistadors, no more than five in total-ish, and the other capitans can lead while we join the raid.
Yeah, I agree.
But first, I gotta show you something. I was out for a while, but while I was out, I found it. I found the mother lode.
Okay, tell us how this plan works again.
We storm the beach with a 50-person raid party and kill Flux on sight. We put all this behind us before he even knows what happened.
Trey, are you serious? That's a stupid plan. That's so stupid.
Why? He's way too paranoid to let an assassin get to him. So Legacy, who he trusts, gets him out in the open. And we have insane numbers against him, so I really don't see a way for him to survive it.
You really think he'll fall for something as simple as that?
I mean, he has no reason not to, and besides, we'll be fine as long as we stick together.
Honestly, it sounds alright to me. We can lead the conquistadors while you guys are gone. May the Rat Queen bless you on your travels.
In cheese we trust. You ready?
Ready.
This has gone far enough. We've all volunteered to join you guys in the raid.
Our time to strike, but we cannot time this poorly. It turns out Flux is on his way back to Luminar right now. We need to strike at the right time.
tray over there. That's one of the assassins.
Oh, I see him. He's getting away. Let's get his ass.
My blood ran cold. Fluixon's schemes and assassins had finally caught up to us, and Trey, my blood brother, had paid the price. Realistically, my safest move now was to lay low with the other conquistadors and let the more involved nations handle taking down Fluix. According to Legacy, his current whereabouts had been uncovered, and a siege was being prepared for the next day. But I saw red. By the time we returned home, I had made up my mind. I think I'm going to die tomorrow, but I don't care. This needs to end.
Yeah, I agree. I'll go with you. You can't go out there alone.
I'll come too. This doesn't sit right with any of us either. There's a good 10 conquistadors who want to join the siege as well.
There's nothing I can say that will convince you not to leave, is there?
No.
I understand. It's just... sometimes I really wish we had stayed a neutral group like we had always planned.
I know. It's just... we're in too deep for that now. For me, at least.
Magmar.
Please. I need to do this. I told him we should stick together, and then I ran ahead because I got carried away.
Okay. Then promise me something else. Come home.
There are 1,000 reasons to stay with the conquistadors, and only one reason not to. But he was worth it. It was time for the conquistadors to finally conquer more than just cheese. It was time for the reckoning. Fluxon's crimes had gone unpunished for too long, and now he would pay the price. The entirety of the Rich Island's militias were called to action, and the turnout was spectacular. And so began the raid on the Ashen Bastion of Infernus.
Megmar, let's go home.
Conquistador, your stallion stands in need of company. And like some angel's haloed brow, you reek of purity. I see your armor plated breast has long since lost a sheath. See no best to unwind. twisted door and vulture sits upon your silk sheet. And in your rusty scabbard now, the sand has taken seat. And all your jewel and crusted plate has not been understood. She has washed the grass your face, taken of its spell. Though I hope for something to find, I could see though.
You know, we're the same, you and I. I'm gay for you, and you're gay for me.
Canary, why are you gay for that guy?
He's hot!
Nice.